Guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing good and keeping safe. So in today's video, we are going to make hibiscus and hummingbird. So let's enjoy coloring. To learn this painting in depth with my personal guidance and support and to find the traceables, you can join me on my online art classes at Patreon. So to get this effect of blending, you can either use a mop brush or a makeup brush, but if both of them are not available with you, so what you can do is that you can use an animal hair brush or synthetic animal hair brush, which is completely distorted and the bristles have split it together so that we can blend them together. So this traceable is also available on my Patreon, and there I will also be teaching you this painting in depth and in slower version. So do join me over there. So I would like to give a tip over here is that whenever you are painting and you see that something is not turning out that well as you thought and the colors are still wet, what you can do is that you can take a wet brush and you can just apply that brush over that area, and using a tissue paper you can just lift the color on your tissue. And this technique will only work if your colors are wet and will not work if your colors have dried. Thank you. So while painting the greenery, you should mix sap green with dark green, because sap green is sometimes kind of translucent and gives a streakiness to our painting. So we either need to apply two coats or we need to mix it with dark green to get an even coat. So for giving the detailings, I'm using a Rigor brush from Brustro brand, because these brushes are very fine and very thin, and these give a very beautiful detailings to our painting.
Thank you.
enjoyed today's video, and if you did, do subscribe to my channel, hit like, and I will see you very soon in my next video. Till then, take care and thanks for watching.